Now that you've mastered the technique of converting a number from standard form into scientific form, the next step is to figure out how do I compare two scientific numbers. The distance around the Earth in kilometers and the weight of the Earth in kilograms are two huge numbers. If those two numbers were written in scientific form, how would you figure out which one's bigger, which one's smaller? The weight of an ant in tons and the weight of one strand of my hair in kilograms are
really tiny numbers.
If those two numbers are written in scientific form, how would you figure out which one's smaller, which one's bigger? In this video, I'm going to show you some strategies on how to compare two scientific numbers. Let's get started. To begin with, let's understand how we write scientific numbers. Scientific numbers have two parts, a decimal part and another part that has powers of 10. The power of 10, if it's positive, that indicates that the number is big. For example, the weight of the Earth or the diameter of the Earth. Those are big numbers, so the power of 10 is going to be positive. But if the exponent of 10 is a negative number, then that tells us that the number is really small. For example, the weight of an ant in kilograms or the weight of a strand of my hair in kilograms, those numbers, the powers of 10 are going to be negative. So if you're comparing two numbers and the powers of 10 have different values, one is positive and the other one's negative, the exponent that is positive will always be bigger than the exponent that's negative. If both numbers are positive, then the bigger positive is the bigger number. If two numbers are both negative, then the opposite is true. The bigger the negative number, for example, negative 5, and you have the other number is -3, then the -3 is a bigger number than the -5. An exponent of -3 indicates that you are only dividing by 10 three times. But if the exponent is getting larger and larger, -5, -10, -100, that means you're dividing by a bigger and bigger power of 10. That number is getting smaller. It's really small. If the two exponents are the same, the two exponents of 10 are exactly the same, then the only thing that you need to do is to compare the decimal part of the scientific number. In the first example, we want to compare two scientific numbers and find out which one's bigger. The two scientific numbers are going to have different values of the exponents. One is positive and the other one's negative. In the first example, we have 2.56 times 10 to the power of 5, and we're comparing it with 4.2 times 10 to the power of negative 7. If you want to compare these two numbers, find out which one's bigger, the only thing that you need to focus on is the exponent. If the exponent here is positive and the other one is negative, positive exponents are always bigger than negative exponents. That means 2.56 times 10 to the power of 5 is bigger than 4.2 times 10 to the power of negative 7. In the second exercise, we need to only compare the two exponents again because they're different. The first one is -4 and the second exponent is +3. All positive exponents are bigger than negative exponents. That means 2.001 times 10 to the power of 3 is a bigger scientific number than 9.45 times 10 to the negative 4. Word of caution, do not compare the decimal part of the scientific number. Do not compare the decimal part because we only compare the exponents of 10. In the final scenario, we're going to look at comparing scientific numbers when we have the same exponent. Both numbers are positive or both numbers are negative and they have the exact same number. So in this example here, we have 3.28 times 10 to the power of +17, and the second scientific number is 4.25 times 10 to the power of +17. In this case, if the two numbers are the same, we really cannot use the exponents to compare the two numbers. Instead, we are going to rely on the decimal part. So we need to compare 3.28 and 4.25. In this case, 4.25 is bigger than 3.28, which means that 4.25 times 10 to the power of 17 is the bigger scientific number. In the second example, the two exponents, we can see that they're the same value, they're both positive, and they're the same number. So that means we need to only compare the decimal part of the number. 5.27 is clearly bigger than 2.139, so that means the first scientific number is the bigger scientific number. In the second exercise, we want to compare scientific numbers that have the same value of the exponent. That means both of them are positive, or the exponents, both of them are negative. In the first example here, we see that the exponent in the first scientific number is a positive 14, and the second exponent is also positive. So if you're comparing two scientific numbers that are both positive, you only look at which of those two numbers is a bigger positive. In the first scientific number, it has an exponent of 14, is clearly the bigger number because 14 is bigger than 12. In the second example, we are comparing 5.15 times 10 to the power of negative 4 and comparing it 6.35 times 10 to the power of negative 5. So in this case, we only need to compare the two exponents. When you have negative exponents, the smaller the negative number is, the bigger that number, that scientific number, is going to be. This is because a negative number indicates how many times you're dividing by a power of 10. So in the first scientific number, we're only dividing 5.15 by a power of 10 four times. So this number here is going to be bigger than the second scientific number because the second scientific number we're dividing by a power of 10 five times.
Here's a quick pro tip. Whenever you're comparing scientific numbers, the first thing you need to do is to look at the exponents of 10. Don't compare the decimal part. First, compare the exponents of 10.
Now that you've learned the basics of comparing scientific numbers, here's a list of countries and their populations. And your task is to arrange these countries in increasing order. That means the smallest number first and the biggest number last. Good luck.